way. If you tell me that I'm fat shaming, then I'm gonna kick you the hell off my island. Do you understand? You got to go. You've got to go. Because it's not, you should be ashamed. Are you kidding me? Eating yourself to near death. Are you kidding me? You should be ashamed. And if you would have flagged your ego, or if you're in therapy right now or in counseling right now, if you're already dealing with insecurity issues, get the hell off my island. You don't need to be here. You've been warned to go back to that other place where they'll show you empathy, apathy, and sympathy, and whatever other pathetic, weak words I can come up with. It's disgusting. It's just pitiful. Pitiful. No mercy. No. Why would I have mercy? Good gosh. All right. Quick housekeeping, and we're going to get right to it. This is a one-week challenge, but we have designed it so that you can string 2 weeks together if you dare. But you, if you choose to do this, and you have to tap out, or I tap you out, then you will earn the Diet Devil badge. And the Diet Devil badge will sit there in your profile and mock you. So do not become an official entrant in this challenge. Do not, if you plan on tapping out, or if you're going to send me one of those silly little messages that, hey, I signed up for this program. I paid to be a member of Shibboleth, and I don't want that devil badge in my profile. That makes me feel like that this is some sort of cult or something. I don't want a devil in my profile, in my journal. It makes me feel bad. If you're going to do that, then get the hell off of my island. Go away. You've made your bed in hell. Just lay there. Stay there. Don't come to my island and expect anything to change if you do what you've always done, and that's quit. In fact, most of you here right now, most of you should go ahead and tap out now. Most of you should go on and tap out now. That's what you're good at. You're good at quitting. And I want you to remain perfect. I want you to remain good at something. I want you to remain good at something. Most of you have only found that you're good at quitting and making excuses. So why not continue to be perfect? Why go and mess that up now by finishing something that you start? There's two ways to tap out. One is honorable, the other is not. One is on the honor system. If you eat off of the meal plan, you should tap yourself out. If you have any doubt about whether you've eaten something off meal plan or not, then you should ask me or one of my assistants, and we will referee you and tell you whether you should tap out or not. Also, there's a dishonorable way to tap out. That is for me to find out you're cheating and I get the proof of it and have to tap you out for you. Now, if you have some sort of medical condition or something like that, look, we don't treat, we don't cure, we don't diagnose. We don't prescribe. We are not doctors, and we do not pretend to be. Everything that we're sharing with you is for entertainment purposes only. So if you've got problems, whether psychological or physical, you need to go talk to your therapist or your doctor. I'm not your therapist or your doctor. These things have worked for me, and they probably won't work for you. So why are we wasting a week with you on this island? Well, if you choose to do this, you're doing this because it's worked for me, but probably won't work for you because you don't have self-discipline and you don't want self-discipline either. Unless you learn self-discipline, that's the discipline of self for all you smart people. If you're not able to deny thyself, if you're not able to discipline yourself, if you're not able to buffet your own flesh, then nothing that I share with you or teach you is going to work. If you've got self-discipline and you're willing to deny yourself and you pick up the tools that we put out there and use those tools, you have a supernatural experience. It will seem to those around you like you have supernaturally lost weight. So if you have questions about what a tap out is, if you put anything off of my meal plan in your freaking mouth, you should tap out. You should do the honorable thing and admit your sugar britches and come back later. That honors those people that are moving forward with self-discipline. But God knows there's a lot of cheaters here too. You just want to earn a badge that you really didn't earn. Doesn't matter. You won't lose any weight if you're cheating. All these hellos. My gosh, you'd think I'm Travis. You'd think that I'm going to speak to each one of you and call you by name, I suppose. But anyway, that we'll leave that crap to Travis. All right, so in the chat box, you should see an option to change your chat to all panelists and all attendees. Please do so now. I will not stop and address everybody that says, why can't everybody see my chat? So you need to stay, and if you can't figure out how to do it, I guess you just won't do it. If it's set to all panelists, only myself will see it. And I won't have time to stop and answer every little petty question tonight. So you want to set it to all panelists and to all attendees so those that have a clue can help those who don't have a clue. Also, if you ask stupid questions, and I deem that it's a stupid question, I will punish the entire group by taking things away or adding things to. If you ask something stupid, I will punish the entire group. Now, we're adults here. You can't make me eat or not eat something. If you want to finish my challenge on the honor system without cheating, you'll have to do what I put out there for you to do. You don't believe me? Go ask some victims from the past. I've tapped their arses out because they were either a smart aleck, made fun, or asked stupid questions. You will be punished. You will be punished. If you want to finish on the honor system, you will be punished. And it won't be good. Last challenge, I had somebody email me and said, you said we couldn't eat anything all day. The human body can go 30 days without eating anything. Some of you can't go an hour and a half. But if you ask stupid questions, make fun of me or someone here, you'll be punished and you might have to go an entire day without any food. Not joking. All right, so let's get this party started. Any questions before we get started? No. Well, let's get this party started. I've got a lot of things going on my screen, so I'm going to have to set it up. We'll get our PowerPoint going. Let's do this first before we get into it. Well, let's do this. Let me give you reasons why you need to do this before. I was going to do this last. I think I'll do this first. First of all, let me give you a little Bible. Let me tell you why you should do this and why you should stop procrastinating. Are you ready? Not my words, God's word. Here's what the Bible says about you being fat. Here's what it says, all you faithful people. Probably some of you went to church tonight and shouted or something, acting like you got the Holy Ghost in you. But yeah, the Holy Ghost and the fruit of the Holy Ghost is what? Self-discipline's one of them, people. Patience is one of them, people. Some of you don't have it. But yet you shouted tonight in the church house because you got the Holy Ghost. I don't know where he went, but some of you ain't got him too good. Here's what the Bible says about you being fat. Here's what it says. I appeal to you, therefore, brothers and sisters, by the mercies of God, present your bodies as a living sacrifice, holy and acceptable to God, which is your spiritual worship. You went to the church. Anybody do that tonight? Went to the church, held up your little holy hands and shouted, got in the choir and sang and looked up like you was worshiping, acting like God's a golden retriever. You gonna pet God and make God feel better. You gotta be kidding me. He says that worship is presenting your bodies a living sacrifice. Says, do not be conformed to this world in the way they eat, but be transformed by the renewal of your mind, that by testing you may discern what is the will of God, what is good and perfect and acceptable. Is it good? Is it perfect? Is it acceptable for you to take the temple that he's given you as a house for your spirit, a temporal home for your spirit? Is it good for you to corrupt it? Is it good for you to wound it, to hurt it, to eat poison and to overeat it? Oh, is that good? Is it good when you're 30, 40, 50 or more pounds overweight to go out after church every time and stuff your face again and then lie to yourself and say, I'll start Monday? Philippians chapter 3, verse 18 through 20. For many of whom I have often told you and now tell you even with tears, walk as enemies of the cross of Christ. Their end is destruction. Their God is their belly, and they glory in their shame. With minds set on earthly things like Mexican devil chips and cheese dip. But don't you know? Our citizenship is in heaven. And from it, we await a Savior, the Lord Jesus Christ. Which will it be? Which will it be? Will you continue to worship your little belly and your little appetites, or will you begin to worship the living God? 1 Corinthians 3:17. If anyone destroys God's temple, God will destroy them. For God's temple is holy. And you are that temple. How many of you went to worship tonight in a church that you care about, that the deacons go care about, that the women go care about, they keep it clean? If somebody vandalized it, you'd pitch a little fit. But yet you vandalize in your own body. You kidding me? Oh, we're going to go into starvation mode, Travis. We're going to go into starvation mode, Jack. Well, you don't want us to go in starvation mode during the challenge, do you? Daniel 1:12, sugar britches, says this. Test your servants for 10 days, Daniel said to the little unit. Let us be given nothing but vegetables to eat and water to drink. They weren't talking about starving to death, were they? But, oh, you hear this and you say, yeah, I get it. But now's not the appropriate time. Making excuses. You've got the excusitis. But I got a birthday coming up over the course of the next week. I don't know if I can do it. Can we do another challenge? Can we catch you another time? How many times have you done that? Because of a birthday or a holiday or an anniversary or whatever it is. How many times? And look at where you're at. You look in the mirror and you're disgusted with yourself. I'm not disgusted at you. I ain't got to look at you. You're disgusted with yourself. Listen to what the Bible says about excuses. But they all, this is Luke chapter 14, verse 18 through 20, but they all alike began to make excuses. The first said, I bought a field and I must go out and see it. Please have me excused. And another said, I bought 5 yoke of oxen and I go to examine them. Please have me excused. And another said, I've married a wife. And therefore, I cannot come. Excuses, excuses, excuses. Genesis 3:13, the Lord God said to Eve, what is this that you have done? The woman didn't say, I take extreme ownership of what I have done. I did this. She said, no, it's not my fault. It's the serpent's fault. And Adam did likewise. Adam blamed it on the woman. How many men folk here now are blaming it on the wives? How many wives are blaming it on the husbands? But they don't support me. We're without any excuse, people. We're without any excuse. Do you hear me? we are without any excuse. Bible says that you and I are without excuse. You are inexcusable. You need to take ownership of where you're at. Joshua says, I'll say straight up, I've messed up this past few weeks. You sure have. You quit. And I have to pay for that, but I'm glad to be here back on track. No excuses for my mistakes. Well, Joshua, as far as I'm concerned, you're a sugar britches. You let life get in the way after losing 100 pounds, and you disappeared. As far as I'm concerned, you're a sugar britches. And until you can stick to it again, you're a sugar britches in my estimation. Go cry on your friend's shoulder. I'm not your friend. All right, let's get this party started. I'm going to share my screen. I'm going to go through a PowerPoint with you, so bear with me. I don't know if I'll be able to see your chat when the PowerPoint's up, so again, bear with me. Sharing my screen. You should see my screen. Redemption Island, what is this about? This is about redemption, people. It's about redemption. It is about redemption. It's time for you to redeem the time. How many of you started off? Get this mic over here. I may not be loud enough. How many of you start out this year and this was going to be the year? This was going to be the year that you got your life back. Well, heck, last year was going to be the year. Probably going all the way back to 2013. You've been saying, I'm going to get lean in 13. I'm going to get lean in 14. And time keeps on slipping. Into the future. It's 2017 now, sugar britches, tear baby. And half the year is gone. More than half of the year is gone. Are you going to redeem the time? If you're going to, then take massive, massive action. Every time you think about drawing back, take hyper massive action. Go crazy and get it done. I mean, what are you waiting for? You've already been there, done that with food. You've made food your life. No, Jack, my husband's my life. My wife's my life. My children are my life. You got a dang funny way of showing it. It looks to me, if I don't listen to what you say, when you got up in the church house and testified, I love you, Lord. I've got an attitude of gratitude. I'm so happy that he's given me a good family, that he's given me a roof over my head, and he's given me a warm blankie at night. You say all that stuff with your mouth, but I can't hear nothing you're saying. It's your actions that speak volumes to me. And if I close my ears and don't listen, and I look at what I see with my eyes, it looks like most of you worship food. I think that's called idolatry. So it's time to redeem the time. Is 7 days going to get it done? Yeah, could. It can give you momentum, and momentum is very important. You can do, some of you are so big, it's going to take you 700 days. But you got to start somewhere. And here's the good news. It gets better every day if you don't quit like Joshua did. A 7-day challenge. You can do anything for 7 days. But here's what's helped me get through challenges like this. Bible says that it's the little children that inherit the kingdom. So I play pretend. I humble myself like a little child, and I go to a place that's in here and in here, and it's my island. I hope you can find your island during the next 7 days. I'm a castaway on my own island. I cut off the world in here and in here, and I focus only on what I can have and not on what I cannot have. If it's not on my island, I can't put it in the orifice under my nose. If I find myself at the Outback Steakhouse because I have to be polite and go out with some folks for a business meal, and there's nothing from Outback Steakhouse on my island, then I eat air. I can do anything for 7 days. Don't you want to experience some things like going and being able to eat whatever you want, as much as you want, in a lean body because you're choosing to take a planned holiday? Or do you want to keep going to the same old crappy places, shoveling the same old crappy food down your throat in a big fat body where you can't even feel good about what you're eating? Most of you, the stuff that you're eating that's killing you, you don't even feel good about it because you know you're experiencing nothing but guilt and regret and shame. But if you had a lean, healthy body because you had a lifestyle of self-discipline, every once in a while, it'd be a real treat to go out and eat. You ain't even enjoying what's killing you, sugar britches. So can you go to the island and focus on what you can't have and not on what you can't have for 7 days? I don't know. Here's the official entry dates, and I will show you in a few moments how to officially enter the group challenge. For those of you that don't even have to look in the pantry, that don't even have to look in the fridge to see if you've got something on the meal list because you've decided, if I got to, I'll eat air till I can get the right stuff. You can start tomorrow. July the 16th is one start date. For those of you that you proceed a little more cautiously, you can start July the 19th. For those of you that want a whole week to get ready, don't know what you're getting ready for, but if you need an entire week to get ready, you can start July the 24th. And I highly encourage some of you to go all the way through both challenges, both the 16th and the 24th one. Don't stop. Instead of losing 10 in 7, lose 15 in 2 weeks, sugar britches. Lord knows you need to. I don't know how some of you, I mean, it's summertime, people. It's summertime. Some of you husbands and wives, it's time to get off the winter coat. You don't need it to stay warm right now. Probably can't stand each other, don't even sleep in the same bed. If you do sleep in the same bed, it's not winter anymore. You don't need to snuggle up and get warm. You need to get rid of those extra layers, not layer, layers of lard. Die, Lord, die. Here's the challenge. It's only a week, so it's an easy one. All right, folks. I'm going to give you meal ideas, and it's pretty exhaustive. It's a pretty exhaustive meal list. If you did the 14-day challenge, you're going to be real familiar with it. But this one works a little different. I don't think I can see the chat. I can't see it. So whatever you're saying will have to wait. I'll be back over there in a moment. But keep chatting. I'm not going to penalize you for chatting. I just can't see it. But I'm going to give you a meal list. The meal list will be in a Facebook group that's designated for you. Will also be on the website. You'll be eating things like a grilled cheese sandwich. But here's what makes this a challenge. There's a downloadable form in the group. I hope everybody can see. It's on the right side of my screen. The black and white Shibboleth War on Weakness meal plan with the blanks. It says breakfast, lunch, and dinner. You'll choose from the meal list. Days 1 through 3, you'll have to write in three meals that you're going to stick to on the island for those 3 days. So if your challenge starts tomorrow, and let's say that you chose the following three meals. Let's say that you chose a grilled cheese sandwich. You chose fish and asparagus. And you chose 1/3 of a hemp bar. There's tons of options, but let's say those are your three. You must write them in. And on the honor system, that's all you can eat for 3 days. That's it. So if I chose those three items, that's all I can have for my meals. No grazing between meals, no snacks, no freebies. There's a small exception for diabetics, but we'll get to that later. Real warriors won't eat but two meals. You'll intermittently fast and boost your metabolism. I thought that's starvation mode. I've done told you. The human body can go 30 days without a morsel. Some of you can't go 4 to 6 hours, so you won't want to be intermittent fasting. But you can't convince me otherwise anymore. As my wife and my friends know, I've been doing it now since October, and the results are profound. Do I look like I'm starving? No, I look like Bad Jack. But you can have three meals if you're a sugar britches. So you'll choose three from the list. Now, day four through seven, you can choose any six others, but you have to stick to those six. You can pull from the first three and then find three more. Or you can come up with an entirely new list, but then the first three that you use must go. So on day four, we find more food, more rations on our island. So I'm going to pull out of here and ask you, does this concept make sense to you so far? All right, I've stopped sharing my screen. Let me look and see what you're saying or asking. Yes, I meant the 17th. I'll correct that. Yes, I meant the 17th. Everybody get it? So we can't eat the same meals the while we're challenged. Is that Joshua again? Joshua, you need to clarify. Speak in full sentences with proper grammar, young man. I don't understand what you're talking about. Can we eat the same meal two or even three? Yes. Yes. What the heck? Hold on, we have an issue. All right, y'all still got me? Yes, it's only a week. So if you choose one of your three meals as a grilled cheese sandwich, you're doing it Shibboleth approved, of course. If you have questions about what Shibboleth approved is because you haven't been coming to class, then you need to find out. But if I have on my list a grilled cheese sandwich and I have one for breakfast, one for lunch, and one for dinner, that's appropriate because that's all that was on our island, along with two other options. Those meals we choose are all you can have for those 3 days. Yes, you're Tom Hanks on Castaway Island. So we can't eat the same meal for all the meals. Yes, you sure can. You can do that, Joshua. You can. If you want to eat a grilled cheese three times a day for 7 days, fine by me. But that don't sound healthy. Let me tell you what ain't healthy. You continuing to eat like you've been eating. This is not for you to do as a lifestyle. This is to get your arse up and get some momentum for you. If you eat two meals per day, like I do, that's acceptable. I'm going to give you a meal list. Somebody's asking, do they have to be category 1, 2, and 4? I'm going to give you a meal list in a moment. Looks like we're all on the same page thus far. Let's go back to our PowerPoint. Y'all very lucky to have me in your life. You sure are. Who else would do this for you? How do you earn the Jack Attack badge at the end of 7 days? Don't put one bite in your mouth that you're not allowed to have or you must tap out. I think we've already sufficiently covered that. Eat 2 to 3 meals per day with no grazing between meals. No snacks, no freebies. If, this says if you are able to walk, then walk. If you can't walk or exercise, then do not. You know who you are. If you're of able body and you're not willing to get at least 10,000 steps a day, then you shouldn't do this. You shouldn't do this challenge. If you're unable to walk because you have a medical condition or you're going to exacerbate a medical condition, then don't walk. This is on the honor system. I'm going to be walking my arse off this week. Those of you that won't have a Fitbit and you want to be friends, then friend me, TravisJack777 on Fitbit, and we'll push one another. But that's not mandatory unless you're of able body. But Travis, I get in at 10 o'clock at night. Then go walk. Beats watching Fox fake news and CNN fake news and all the propaganda, the bullshito that they're putting out there. Both sides of it. Disgusting. All right, we're getting to the meat of things. Getting to the meat of it. Support, downloadables, updates, meal ideas, grocery list can be found. This is the only thing I think you need to write down. And I'll put it in the chat box in a moment. Maybe somebody can do it for me. This is the Facebook support group, where I and my assistants will be refereeing. https://facebook.com/groups/Redemption Island 7. Redemption Island 7. That's where you're going to need to go for updates and for interaction with moi. Now, we're going to allow you to add people to this group. But note, if they start asking stupid questions, it will penalize the entire group. So as a member, you should be very, very careful about letting people in this group. You should only let people, we're going to do it different this time because we have a small team and it works them to death to have to scrub everybody getting into the group to make sure they're a member. This is only 7 days, so we're not going through that hassle. You are able to add non-sugar britches to the group. But beware, because if you add some ignoramus, some troll, they'll cause this entire group to be punished. So beware about letting people in. It is not mandatory. I'm going to be doing it. And people always ask why I'm doing it. I take Advocare Metabolic Nutrition System and I drink Spark. And because I'm doing this with you this week, you'll see. I'm going to hustle. I'm going to show you it can be done. I'm going to be your drill sergeant. I'm going to be drinking a lot of Spar. So that's the only thing that we would say is not mandatory that we've discussed so far. It's optional, and it's going to give you much, much better results, especially if you're doing this for 2 weeks. Some of you lose 15 to 20 pounds. You don't believe me. The last group, we had people lose, a couple people lose more than 20 in 14 days. One person, I believe it was 26 pounds. Does it matter if you only lose five? If you've only got 10 to lose, it may not be but five. But that five pound of extra layer of lard coming off your arse is going to make you look and feel so much better. Now, I've got some other things to show you. I'm going to show you our meal list. I'm going to show you how to be an official entrant, and I'm going to answer intelligent questions. All right, let me check questions again. My dog eats same kibble two times per day and is excited. That's right, Sandy. And if we'll get it as excited as your dog, we might be successful. So for 3 days, we have three options to choose from. And for the days 4 through 7, you have more options, correct, that you'll choose. Now, good question, good point brought up. So no penalty here. If you go through 7 days and want to continue for 7 more, you have to start all over. Day 1 through 3, day 4 through 7. I have been intermittent fasting and I just have one meal a day. Bio coffee in the morning at dinner, lunch is approved meal. If you feel as great, I can't see the full name, I just see 3 letters, and. If you feel as great as I do, and you do that, yes, because guess what? It's what I do. I lost more than 100 pounds and stayed at anywhere from 210 to 220. I'm 6'3" for many, many years. I turned it up by incorporating exercise, supplementation, and Shibboleth-approved intermittent fasting. And I feel fantastic. And I look it too. You do not have Facebook. Can you get it another way? Yes, on the website. On the website. We'll be in the video section under challenges tomorrow. Thank you, folks, for helping with the group there. The Facebook group is available now. What about Zero Drag Vitamins Plus Pro instead of Advocare? Terrific option. The reason that we did those, when we first come out with those, I took those and I quit taking Advocare vitamins. I quit taking MNS because I felt like I had a good substitute for MNS, which was Vitamins Plus Pro and weight loss and energy. We can no longer manufacture weight loss and energy. We will continue with our vitamin. It's a great vitamin. And it's an economical way to get your vitamin in, a quality vitamin. So, yes, you can do that. I don't know. You'd have to ask those folks. The Advocare link, there you go. Thank you so much, Joshua. Thank you so much, Sasha. There is an Advocare link. If you'll do what I do, I don't just talk it. I walk it. If you'll do what I do, you'll be successful. There is no trick. There is no gimmick. It's hard work. And it's doing it all. You do it all. If you just do the nutrition, you'll look good in your clothes. If you'll do the nutrition and you'll do the supplementation and you'll do the exercise every day, you'll look good naked. Is it worth it? Yeah. Just ask Jack's wife. Updates, everything will be on the website. If you can get the Extreme Stack, yes. If you still have some, yes, we won't be able to carry it any longer. Manufacturer was requiring a $15,000 order moving forward. Our small ministry could not do that. We hated to see it go. We loved it. It works. But we don't have any of that anymore. Just have the vitamin. ACV is always allowed. ACV is always allowed. Sasha has posted the group again. Please tell us your daily diet. I don't know if that's for me or for someone else, Marie. You will be able to rewatch this as many times as you can stand it. My diet is has changed over the years. I did basic shibboleth when I started. Lost 44 pounds in 6 weeks. Didn't have near the variety you guys have now, today. Then over the years, I progressed and I started eating more grocery items from the inner aisles, not just the perimeter. Things that were combined the right way. And I got my weight off. I kept my weight off for years that way. I've always wanted to look good naked. Bare arse. It's my goal. Doesn't have to be your goal, but I wanted it. Redemption, revenge, whatever you want to call it. Everybody that ever hurt me, I wanted to look good naked for. You know who hurt me the most? I hurt myself. No self-respect, no self-reliance. Now I look good naked. I'm proud of my naked body, and I don't care who likes it, who don't. I worked hard for it, and I like it. You might have another goal. But to get there, I had to incorporate 3-4 days a week minimum intermittent fasting or what we call WOW challenge meal plans. That's the new term for some of that. Fun way to do intermittent fasting. I had to, you might think, lift weights or I do several different things, but I'm going to tell you what did the most for me and people will laugh at me. I don't care. I do several different things, but when it comes to dropping fat, supplementation and lots of walking while intermittent fasting will blow towards the booty. Now, I still have holidays. I really don't have any less holidays than I have over the years. Have 6-7 a month, whatever, where I let my hair down and have whatever I want. Can we still, hope that helped, Marie. Can we still have a bio coffee while doing the challenge? No, not unless it's on a, you're going to get several options that we're about to go over. Not unless you're following one of the WOW Challenge meal plans, which are going to be allowed. If you pick out a WOW Challenge meal plan that has bio coffee, then you can do that. But otherwise, you'll have to stick to your meal list. We're getting there. Yes, there are phone apps that can count steps and that will get the job done. We've done several intermittent fasting videos and we will do more. Anybody else? All right. So let's go to our Facebook group. Let's look at the meal list. Let's look at WOW Challenge meal plans. Any vegetarian options? Yes, absolutely. If you want to eat nothing but what they had in the Garden of Eden, go for it. Should have been doing that all along, Sugar Britches, Judy. All right, so let's go to the Facebook group. Hold on. I'm going to share this with you. All right. So here we go. We're going to share. Okay. You should be here in, you should be seeing the Redemption Island 1 Week Challenge group. You should be seeing the group. So here's the way we're going to do this. First of all, I'm going to keep this pinned to the top. I'm going to keep this pinned to the top. Let me go and let all y'all in that's wanting in. This is going to be easy. Usually we have to pull each one of you up. I'm just going to let y'all in because I'm going to run everybody off anyway. My job is to tap your easily offended arse out, and I plan on doing it. By the way, if I tap you out because you did something stupid and I don't feel like fooling with you, you can request back in. Does everybody hear that? Make sure everybody's got this. If I have to put up with too much stupidity, I'm just going to tap you out. But you can request back in. You are not going to get... You're not going to be able to make an excuse for quitting. Well, Jack tapped me out last time. My friend and warrior Cleo had a down day and tapped out. What is this about? Don't tap out. Freaking beg back in. You do whatever it takes to be successful. You don't quit. You be like the guy from Officer and the Gentleman when the drill sergeant was saying, I want your drop on request. I want your DOR. You do like Mayo did in the movie, and you go, I won't quit. Don't you do it. Don't you do it. I got no place to go. That's what you do. You don't quit. All this quitting crap. Sugar britches. Anyway, can y'all see my screen? Let me make sure. I'm having a good time. Everybody see my screen? All right, let me go back and share it again. All right, right here at the top, you'll see it says, please add your meal request to this thread. Jack will attend to it at his leisure. Do not eat the requested meal or ingredient without Jack's approval, or you must tap out. If I don't get to it in time, you know what you do? You eat air, or you avoid that ingredient or that meal. Because if you're wrong, you might have to tap out, sugar britches. Now, the reason we've got these pictures here, I want to remind you what type of people ask for more meals. I want to remind you what type of people ask for more food. Travis, Jack, this is awful. You're shaming me. This guy here was me. And until I put a boot up his arse, he didn't fix it. This was me, people. This was me. And I had to put a boot up his arse. But yet, at the same time, still love him. I had to still love myself. But I had to love myself enough to look in the mirror and say, I love you where you are, but you're going somewhere else. And you got to put the work in, Travis. These are the type of people that in a 1 week challenge ask for more. But if you must, then you must go through the shame of asking in this thread. That doesn't mean you're going to be penalized. If it's something that's necessary, humble yourself and ask in humility. I'll get to it and I'll let you know yes or no. Here's your link for AdvoCare products. Those of you that are diabetics, please ask your questions and make your comments in this thread, but please read. Let me say it for the third time, maybe the second. We don't treat, cure, diagnose, or prescribe. Everything we do is for entertainment purposes only. It is on you to go to your doctor with this meal list and ask your doctor, is this okay for you to do for 1 week? When you're on medications and you make radical behavioral changes like you're making here, you may not need the same dose anymore. I can't measure that for you. I can't monitor that for you. You're responsible for your health. Everybody got it? I'm not. You and your doctor should take this entertainment. You should take this entertainment to your doctor so your doctor can say, why would you want to do this? Best practices. You want it bad? You want it faster? Declare war on your weakness. Here are the WOW Challenge meal plans. Now, this is important. Everybody wake up for a minute. Wake up. This is important. Remember the little black and white handout? Remember the handout? If you're going to do the challenge meal plans, if you're going to do those, you must write in one of your blanks, W-O-W. In other words, that has to fill one of your blanks. You can't have all those options and go do WOW Challenge meal plans. So let me show you where to find them so that you can decide if you want to do them. And by the way, best practices other than WOW Challenge meal plans. Rule number one, skip it. That's your problem. You ain't skipped enough meals in your life. Two, rule number two, skip it. Rule number three, skip it. Rule number four, 2 meals per day with no grazing between meals. We'll get it off if you don't have a pre-existing health condition. Drink water, take your supplements, walk, and then walk some more. 10,000 steps are for sugar bridges. If you're an able-bodied person, get your arse out there and do 20,000 and watch how the weight falls off this week. Stay busy, get your mind off of food. Let food become an afterthought instead of your first thought of every day and your last thought of every freaking night. Live for something else for a week. Number nine, self-discipline. Number 10, don't quit. Don't quit. Don't let me kick you out. Don't let me tap you out. Don't quit. 11, don't bow to the diet devil. And there was another one you can't see. Number 12, submit yourself to God. Whoever you call on, whoever your faith calls on, bow, submit. But don't submit to your weakness and don't submit to the diet devil for a week. All right, let me show you the challenge meal plan so you can determine if you want to put that in one of your blanks. It's kind of like going, y'all ever watch Naked and Afraid? They get to take one survival item with them. You're getting to take your survival food with you. You have to determine what survival foods you want to take. So you log into the website and you go to resources. And then you go to challenges right here. And when you go to challenges, you'll see War on Weakness Challenge Meal Plans. And you'll see a listing of all the ones that you can do. Then, if we were just having a War on Weakness challenge, you could just do that and you'll get great results. Marvelous, life-changing results. So you could put in your blank, WOW challenges, and you could choose from any one of these. And rest assured, you're going to get fantastic results. But you may not have, if you're starting tomorrow, you may not have the ingredients you need. In the Facebook group, you're going to see a link with all of the meals that you can select. I just went to that link, by the way. It says breakfast, lunch, dinner, so on and so forth. if you don't want to buy a thing from Shibboleth, you don't have to. You're going to have to go through here and pick out things you can get from the grocery store. But you're only getting a max of 6 items anyway. So I would look through here, and I would determine which things that I could stick to for 1 week and which things I could get to the grocery store or the center and get. I want to give you kind of another rule. Less bread is best. So when you start selecting these, if you select a grilled cheese, just note that bread always, even approved bread, slows you down some. So in other words, for me this week, one of the things that I've chosen is an approved turkey sandwich. But instead of bread, I'll have it in a lettuce wrap. And I'm always going to approve that substitution. I'll get better results by having it in a lettuce wrap as opposed to having it with bread. But if the only way you like it's with bread, have the bread. You're still going to get great results. Some of you so big, you won't know the difference. So you're going to choose things that you know you will do and can do for days 1 through 3 and 4 through 7. And don't forget, if you're going to be choosing the WOW Challenge meal plans, write that in. Because when it comes to refereeing, I may ask you for your worksheet at the end of this challenge. If I feel like there's been a lot of cheating going on, I may ask you for your worksheet at the end of the challenge. Same thing for like an approved hot dog. I might have my hot dog Frank with lettuce, ketchup, mustard, sauerkraut. It's just for a week, people. Less is best. But this is your official meal list. Unless I approve other meals from that post that I showed you earlier. If you place your meal in the box and I approve it, it will get added to this link. This link will stay updated at all times. Has everybody got that? If you're reading this and you're new here and you say, I want a tomato sandwich, it says tomato sandwich, approved bread, Kraft fat-free mayo, 1 tablespoon of hemp flakes. Let's say you don't know what that is. Ask and somebody will come to your rescue and help you. If you don't get your question answered quick enough, then you should eat air. It's real simple. It's a challenge, 1 week challenge. We're all flying to the island. One more thing I need to show you, and then I'll look and answer questions again. I got to go to the website to show you how to be an official entrant. You go to this tab where it says challenge. You go to this tab, and you'll see Redemption 1, Redemption 2, Redemption 3. It won't let you sign up for Redemption 3 yet. It's not quite time. But you can go on and sign up for 1 or 2. And it's going to ask you for 2 photos. I don't care what those 2 photos are. It could be your last 2 photos that you've done. But for the system to accept you as an official entrant, you must enter those 2 photos. Let's go back and look at a previous challenge that's over. Let's go look at 14-day do or die metabolic boost challenge. You can see all the people that officially entered. Some quit, some tapped out. If they put their weight in, you can see their weight loss. You got 6.6 in 2 weeks, 7.5, 7. As I go down here, I see lots of 7s in 2 weeks, which means they were losing 0.5 pound a day. Joshua, 12.6. There's some 20 pounds in here somewhere. 11. A lot of good results. Some people might have had a private profile and you can't see it. But anyway, great results. Here's all the people. Most people tapped out, by the way. Almost everybody taps out within the first 2 days of a challenge. And believe it or not, a lot tap out on the last day of a challenge because of self-sabotage. But you'll want to be an official entrant by accepting the group challenge right here if you're starting tomorrow, if you're starting Wednesday, right here. Does this make sense? Let me stop and see what questions you have. There is a lot of variety. However, you won't have a lot of variety. Remember, choose wisely. Ooh, I will add the food list. Yes, I will add it in the Facebook group. Has everybody found the Facebook group? We will add it as soon as I'm done here. There is a misspelling in that link. Don't pay attention to the link. Just use the link that I put in a moment. Let me see if I can go on and give it to you here too. Yeah, I'll have to go back and grab it in a little bit. Any other questions? If you're in the Facebook group or on the website, you'll have the link momentarily. Any accommodations for breastfeeding mothers? I think that you've got plenty of food. I don't know that I would intermittent fast if you're breastfeeding. I think I would have the three meals. And certainly if you've been using hemp hearts and that's a request because you're a breastfeeding mother, then please go ahead and add a tablespoon of hemp hearts to any meal. Hemp hearts are great for milk production. Yes, you still have a 50-calorie condiment option. Condiments are approved. That's not a stupid question. I'll be approving everybody here in just a few minutes. I've already approved a lot of people. Let me go ahead and the rest of you can also approve people. Yes. I don't see any more requests right now. Shows everybody that wanted in has been added. It really isn't going to matter about your ounces. Follow your normal shibboleth portion rule. But if you're one of a person, an individual that wants to weigh it, you want to be that strict with yourself and not just use the hand rule. Or if it says like, okay, it says like 2 to 4 ounces or whatnot, that is pre-cooked weight. This video will be on the website. No, if you do a WOW challenge, you do it for that one day. In other words, if you want to use WOW challenges as an option, it has to be written in on your worksheet. But then you can choose any of them, giving you a lot of variety. The problem with the WOW challenge meal plans, it's why you need to be careful if you select them. A lot of those items on that list are specialty items. That's why you get better results. They're specialty items. If you're going to stay strictly with grocery items, probably need to avoid the WOW Challenge meal plans. I'm adding 44 more people right now. 44 more people just got added. The WOW Challenges are the best for helpful, fast weight loss. Any other questions or comments about this challenge, the scope of this challenge, anything? Each day as we progress, I will tighten up on the stupid questions. But right now is the time to ask semi-stupid questions. I would love for you to post the worksheets. I would love for some of you warriors to post the worksheets and show some of these sugar britches how it's done. Yes, you can use no calorie water flavor enhancers. Any freebie beverage, any approved beverage, any shibboleth approved beverage is allowed. Except for bio coffee. That's not a beverage. That's a supplement. We drink it like a beverage, but it's a supplement. Otherwise, approved beverages, Sprite Zero, approved. Crystal Light, approved. I listed three freebies for diabetics. Advocare Rehydrate, Healthy Warrior Bars, and as a grocery option, Peanut Butter and Company Peanut Butter. Now, under the diabetic thread, hopefully you are paying attention. I posted a diabetic thread. If there's something that you usually do as a freebie that works for you when your sugar drops because you're making these radical changes and your body doesn't need as much insulin, then ask. You're less likely to get roasted by me asking there. Good night. Cleo, it's very similar. Yes, it is the same right now, but it will be changing. We're going to be, as we move forward, we're going to be penalizing people, moving stuff and all kind of things. So, Angie, almost borderline stupid question. Way to go, Angie. You're just about to get everybody penalized. No! You can't. 7 days in a row. 7 days in a row. You cannot do it half arse and then come back and do another half arse and that equal a whole arse. Doesn't work that way. 7 days in a row. Do it or don't do it. Peanut butter in an approved wrap. Well, I guess you'll have to look at the list when you get in the Facebook group and when I post the full list, which will be right after I get off of here. You'll have to look and see if it's on the list. If it's not on the list, can she have it? No! Borderline. So if I do the same wow on the first 3 days, do I have to choose another wow for day? No. You can choose, if you write wow in your little blank, you can choose any of the wows and you can do the same wow every day if you want to for 7 days and lose more weight than everybody else. Sugar britches. So do we pick three meals on the 4th through the 7th? Three new meals. You can get rid of the old three and add 6 new ones. You got sick and tired the first 3 days of a grilled cheese? Then don't put that on day 4 through 7. You can add 3 more meals or you can do an entirely new 6. But you have to focus on what's written in the blank. If it's not written in the blank, you can't have it. And you can't scratch one out and add another one midway through. You have to decide before the challenge begins what your three and six items are. And you've got to stick to it. It's called self-discipline. You said you were going to do it. You got to stick to it. You can't change courses. Just when things get a little hairy in the middle of the challenge, that's our problem. So easy. We're all such babies. People across this world, they don't have a warm bed to sleep in tonight. They don't have a toothbrush. They don't have clean water to brush their little teeth. They don't have any rations to eat tomorrow. And we a bunch of tear babies and sugar breeches. Celsius is an approved beverage. Drink up. I am a savage. You must be a savage with yourself. Maybe not outwardly like I'm acting right now. That's because y'all love me. But I love y'all. Oh, what? Sorry. I hate when that happens. Go away. Exercise the Travis demon. All right. So I'm going to play a little music. And I'm going to go put that link where y'all need it. And all that kind of stuff. Thank you, completely computer illiterate. Well, you won't be when we get done with you. All right, we're done here. I'll be reading your questions and posting links and all that kind of stuff. Let's get that lard off your arse. Will you please declare war on your weakness and do me a favor? Strive to be unoffended during the challenge. It's for fun. We're having a good time. Not really. Good night, Sugar Britches. Remember, I'm going to tap you out. I'm going to.
All gathered round, they gazed in wild wonder at the joy they had found. The head nurse spoke up, said, "Leave this one alone." She could tell right away that I was bad to the bone, bad to the bone, bad to the bone, bad.
Hey, a little bit overtime, like a Marvel movie. It's just the thought. I just got pissed off. Maybe most everybody's gone now, so I can really get pissed off. Can I say something to you? Can I? I'm going to anyway. Get rid of your pathetic, pathetic, groveling, low down, bless your heart, freaking excuses. You act like there's no reward by you doing this. Think about what you have to gain here, Sugar Britches. Think about it. Get fired up and just think about what you've got to gain here. Self-respect, looking good, feeling good. Think about it. 7 days, you might lose 10 pounds. Isn't that worth fighting for? Get rid of your pathetic excuses. You know what the definition of pathetic is? It's that you act sad at heart. You act wounded to get other people to feel sorry for you, to give you something. I got news for you, Sugar Britches. Ain't nobody gonna do this for you. Nobody owes you anything. You gotta do this for you. And in order for most of you to do it for you, you're gonna have to totally, 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 totally reinvent yourself inside here and inside here. Toughen up. Stop being pathetic excuse makers. That's what the rest of the world is. Now stop it. You're better than that. And you know you are. Dadgummit.
Before I make you, I'll break 1,000 more, baby.
What's it going to feel like? What's it going to feel like? Can I just be real with you for a minute? Can I be real? Can I be real with you? We ain't got many people left, so I can be real. Because God orders your steps. Let me tell you why I do what I do. And it wouldn't have looked good naked. Can I be real with you now? I'm going to be real with you. Here's why I did it. I got sick and tired. Of being sick and tired? No. I didn't get sick and tired of being sick and tired. I didn't get tired of taking my blood pressure medicine. I didn't get tired of acid reflux and the cup because I got used to it. I got used to taking that high cholesterol medicine. I got used to it. It's amazing what you can get used to when you ain't got no self-confidence. Let me tell you why I eventually did it. Revenge, baby. Revenge. People making fun of me. People laughing at me. People hurting me. People abusing me. Not believing in me. Making fun of the way I speak. Making fun of the way I look. Since I was a child. Carried over into my adult relationships. Always bowing. Always giving in. Always being pathetic. Screw that.
You know what success really is, or what revenge is? Being successful. Oh, they won't come to you and say, "You look good, sister." They won't. They tell you, "You look sick." They won't tell you, "Oh, brother, look, you looking good." They won't tell you that. They won't tell you that. They don't want you to know that. They want to pull you back down so you can continue being beneath them. You understand what I'm saying? They want you to continue being beneath them, lower than them, where you've always acted like you belong. They want to pull you back down. Some of you got some hurt. Some of you a little pissed off inside, and I'm bringing it back up. Now you're starting to get a little righteous indignation, and you say, "I'll show them." Let me tell you something. They may never, you haters, you naysayers, they may never come and say, "Dang, you did it. You look good, girl. Man, I wish I'd held on to you." They may never do that. But you'll know in their heart, they know they lost a good one. Be successful. Every minute of every day, instead of you sniffing out the next morsel of bread, instead of you doing that and acting stupid and being what they want you to be, subservient, instead of sniffing out that, sniffing out the next donut, sniffing out the next Krispy Kreme, sniffing out the next deep dish pizza, sniffing out mama's spaghetti and meatballs, sniffing out grandma's red velvet cake. Instead of sniffing out that, why don't you sniff on something else, your goals? Why don't you get up in the morning and think about that? And when they say, "Are you eating?" Go, "I forgot all about it." "Well, what have you been doing?" "I've been sniffing out my goals. I'm going to look good naked. I don't care if you like it or not. I'm unplugging from the matrix. I'm going to plug in to the new me. I'm going to reinvent myself. Ain't nobody to stick a finger in my face anymore to tell me I can't do something, by George. They all eat crow." See, I can't shut up because now I can see you messages. I like it, Lisa. It's time to work on me and not worry about what anybody else thinks. Hey, man, that's what it takes. I get tired of patronizing everybody else, the Shibboleth family. What we really need, instead of all that petting, we've been petted rotten. Need somebody to say, "Then don't do it. You're going to wind back and plumb it. Don't do it. Go on. Get. Go." We need people. We want to surround ourselves with people that believe in hard work. God. You going to sell out? You going to sell my birthright? You going to sell my blessing for some Mexican devil chips dipped in the cheese dip? Really? A soulless object like a chip is going to lord over me and control me? I don't think so. Going to allow all my enemies to live life in front of me while I'm on the outside looking in? I don't think so. I'm going to do this while everybody watches God prepare a table just for me. And you know what I'm going to do, whether people like it or not? I'm going to say, "I did it." And then I'm going to raise my hands up in the air and I'm going to say, "But it wasn't by my might. Blessed be the name of the Lord." You want results like this? You better bless the name of the Lord on the good days and on the bad days. Some of y'all need to start doing something for yourself.